labels want my name beside an X like Malcolm. Everybody got a deal, I did it without one.
He's the golden boy from Canada.
I'm proud to be Canadian, you know, that's all.
And the rap world's most promising new star.
I did it overnight, it couldn't happen any quicker.
Lil Wayne has taken him in like a little brother.
Wayne inspires me really to do all this stuff.
And he's worked with every legend in the game. From Jay-Z to Kanye West.
Everyone who doubted me is asking for forgiveness. If you ain't been a part of it, at least you got to witness.
With hip-hop royalty in his corner, he's on his way to inheriting the throne of the new rap world.
It's about time you admit it. Who you kidding, man? Nobody's ever done it like I did it.
Legions of fans waited anxiously for his debut album.
I just want to be successful.
Making him the most hyped and anticipated rapper of all time.
One thing about music, when it hits you, feel no pain.
He represents the new generation.
I know this isn't it. I know this isn't the peak. I know there's always more to strive for, more to attain. The goal should always be to be one of the greats, you know, to be the best.
Hey, hey, hey. Drake was born to be.
I can honestly say, you know, there was a period in my life where I was in high school, and I used to have trouble, you know, going to sleep at an early hour because I used to sit there and dream about hearing my name called, you know, at a Grammy nomination press conference, something like this.
Drake was at the Grammys, and with two nominations, the young rapper's meteoric career had reached an all-time high. He'd become hip-hop's hottest freshman. But for every fan, there was a skeptic. The new rap star still hadn't released a full-length album. And many wondered if he was worth the hype. The last and only Canadian rapper to make it big out of the Great White North was Snow, an early 90s one-hit wonder. And as a former child TV star, Drake lacked the street cred and gangster persona many rap legends are made of. The pretty boy MC looked like he should be fronting a bubblegum pop band, not rhyming alongside a tattooed and battle-scarred veteran like Lil Wayne. So as Drake stepped on stage to close out the 2010 Grammys with his smash hit Forever, millions of people around the world were watching.
Last name ever, first name greatest, like a sprained ankle, boy, ain't nothing to play with.
And everybody was waiting to see if the golden boy from Toronto could actually deliver. Growing up as a biracial boy, Aubrey Drake Graham quickly learned what it was like being the outcast. Whether it was in the wealthy Forest Hill community of Toronto, where he was raised by his Jewish Canadian mother, or in the deep south of Memphis, where he visited his African American father, Aubrey never quite fit in anywhere. But that would all change at the age of 14, when Drake landed a role on the hit TV series Degrassi, The Next Generation.
Think about turning 14, it's like I'm a man now.
And quickly became one of the most popular cast members on the show.
Acting in Degrassi was a great thing, and what I enjoyed most about it was it's an art form, it's a way to express yourself, and you know, you get to let a lot of things out in acting.
Drake turned out to be a natural in his new role on Degrassi, playing Jimmy Brooks, a high school basketball star who becomes paralyzed after getting shot by a classmate.
I go through a lot. I got shot last season, so I have a lot of accepting to do in my life, a lot of changes to make.
In the show, Jimmy turns to rap as a way of expressing his emotions, and the role was a perfect fit, as Drake had become a hip-hop fanatic. And before long, Drake's first love of acting was replaced by a burning desire to make music.
The one thing that always threw me off about acting was the amount of things you have to wait for. You have to wait for so many things to fall into place before you can actually do your job. Like, you gotta get the audition, you gotta have a project that's for you, you have to, you know, get the part, and then the project has to get greenlit, and it was just like the process of waiting to work. I don't like waiting to work.
At the age of 16, more and more consumed by music, the young teenager made a bold decision that shocked his mother and radically reshaped his life. Choosing to drop out of high school, Drake would use the extra time to become a full-on student of hip-hop, passionately studying American rap legends like Jay-Z.
Jay is like my guy. He's my hero, you know?
Delving deeper and deeper into hip-hop, Drake would discover his true calling in life.
I finally found what I was meant to do, because I wasn't meant to go to high school. I wasn't meant to play basketball. You know, I found these things out through the course of my life.
February 2006. 4 years had passed, and at the age of 20, Drake released his first mixtape. But local rap heads within the Toronto scene were skeptical, and many laughed at the thought of the Degrassi star becoming a credible rapper.
I'm not my character on that show. I'm me. You have the option of getting involved in my life or just getting involved in the person that you see me as.
Living in his mother's basement, the fledgling MC refused to give up and released his second mixtape 1 year later. And this time, he would use his own money to make a music video for a song from the tape called Replacement Girl. I'm far from the man that I used to be, and I don't ever really kick game. I know you find it impressive whenever you introduce to me.
So many ways to look corny in a music video. So getting on camera and like trying to look cool is like a whole different story. You know, it's not Degrassi, it's another ball game.
Replacement Girl paid off big time when BET caught hold of the video and named it Best New Joint of the Day on April 30th, 2007, making Drake the first unsigned Canadian to ever have a video featured on the network. Suddenly, the determined rapper gained some respect and credibility in his hometown, where people were beginning to warm to his signature sound and witty wordplay. So questioning me is nonsense. My advancements are definitely
something that you rappers pressing to see, and I can do that. Recently, I've become more confident in the fact that people accept my brand of music. I bring drama in town, but don't worry, I'ma pull
my pants up when your mama around. But as the Toronto rapper grew more successful and confident, he dreamed of expanding outside the city's borders into an international star who could be heard around the world.
I know this isn't it. I know this isn't the peak, you know? So I know there's always more to strive for, more to attain.
Little did he know, the answer to his dreams was just one short phone call away.
Hi, sweetheart.
Hey, Mom.
Look at you, your purple outfit in your bow.
Look, let's rewind with the Hoover T-Series Rewind. It's lightweight, easy to maneuver, great on all floor surfaces with no loss of suction. Really get the dirt off the floor with more channels of suction. That's patented wind tunnel technology. So when you clean, do it right the first time with the Hoover Wind Tunnel T-Series Rewind.
Hoover, nobody does it like you.
At Kinder, we want to know, have you played today?
December 2008. Drake was sitting in a Toronto barbershop getting his hair cut when his cell phone started ringing. What happened next was the stuff of urban legends.
It was surreal at the time. I was getting my hair cut, so it was like, you know, I rarely pick up the phone when I'm getting my hair cut, but it was a long distance number.
Wheezy, aka Lil Wayne, the number one rap artist in the world, was on the other end, asking Drake to jump on the next flight to Houston.
For him to do what he does and recognize the talent in me coming from Canada and hearing like I was on a TV show and still want to be like, yo, fly this kid out right now, because I know. And for it to be going as well as it's going, it kind of seems like it was meant to be.
Drake would spend the next 2 weeks crisscrossing America aboard Lil Wayne's tour bus for the I Am Music tour. They say I'm rapping like Big J and
Tupac, Andre 3000. Wayne inspires me really to do all this stuff. He's like really my mentor, you know? I've never had a mentor or somebody to look up to. I look up to Wayne.
The two rappers were from different worlds, but they formed a brotherly bond.
But I think we'll always have that sort of like little brother relationship. Like he's always proud of me. And like it's the same thing to have him on the side watching my show, knowing that like you put me here, you know? And that's an amazing thing.
Initiated into Lil Wayne's Young Money crew.
Young money thieves, steal your love and leave.
Drake had landed the opportunity of a lifetime.
You're in the presence of one of the greatest, and I really have to pull my weight, you know, because he's vouching for me, so I better come through.
And audiences all across America began embracing the rapper as one of their own.
I think that I blend well with the Americans, as they say. They're not like, oh, that's some Canadian music. It's good for Canadian music. Like, they just say it's good music.
Years of studying and emulating the great American rappers began paying off.
And the great part about it is because I'm not from one place, I can go to Houston and Houston accepts me as a Houston artist. And I go to New York radio embraces me like I'm a New York artist. It's like I belong to a whole bunch of different places because I'm not from any of them.
But just when things were looking up, the unsigned artist found himself at a crossroad. Record labels were pressuring Drake to conform to the typical rap stereotype. After some soul-searching, the rapper decided to stay true to himself and refused to create a fake gangster persona.
The way I would describe my sound, though, is genuine. It's authentic. I try and always keep it, like, true to me.
And my mother tried to run away from home, but I left something in the car, and so I caught her in the driveway.
Choosing to rap about his own real-life experiences, Drake would roll the dice, gambling that he could strike a chord with fans on a more personal level.
I just figured, you know, I'm at this point in my life, it's a rush, it's all happening, and as it unfolds, it would be amazing to tell this story, because it's not all good. You learn, there's ups and downs, and so I just tried my best to tell that story.
He would also gamble on a new sound, singing almost as much as he rapped, to create a much more emotional style, setting him apart from the hip-hop pack. February 2009. The gamble paid off, and Drake's third mixtape, So Far Gone, spread across the internet like wildfire, becoming one of the most downloaded mixtapes of all time, exploding beyond the rapper's wildest dreams.
I owe my father a lot because my father for years was telling me to sing, and I would always fight him. My dad would always be like, look, if you're gonna rap, you gotta do this stuff too, because the world relates to this stuff. You have to incorporate singing into it. You gotta incorporate this soul and this thing that touches adults and children alike.
It may not mean nothing to y'all, but understand nothing was done for me.
Fans went crazy for his fresh approach, proving that people were tired of the same old rap formulas and ready for something new.
It's always nice when people say, you sound like the next Jay or you sound like the next Wayne, but you know, it's even better when they say, like, you sound like the first Drake.
Drop the mixtape that sounded like an album. Who'd have thought a countrywide tour be the outcome?
MTV voted So Far Gone the hottest mixtape of 2009. And Drake's songs seem to offer something for everyone.
People are now used to the fact that when I rap, I tell my story. So they know what they're gonna get. They're obviously gonna get me rapping about me genuinely. And I hope that by expressing my emotions, it applies to you too, and we can relate and meet on that common ground. The most amazing thing is to go see like people from completely different walks of life singing my songs like it's their words.
Meanwhile, even the most serious rap heads couldn't deny Drake's lyrical prowess.
Yeah, and y'all don't even have to ask twice. You can have my heart and we can share it like the last slice.
Oh, the hit single, Best I Ever Had, became a summer anthem, shooting straight to number one on the Billboard charts, earning Drake two Grammy nominations, thrusting him into the spotlight as hip-hop's brightest new star. And with that, the young rapper officially put Toronto on the international hip-hop map.
When I would go around playing shows in the U.S., like, the past few years and whatever, they'd be like, where you from? I'd be like, Toronto. They'd be like, that's cool, that's cool. Now I'm like, Toronto, they like Drake.
All these people are just kind of being like, this kid's from Toronto, Toronto this, Toronto that. Wayne's saying Toronto in songs.
I can put you in the condo, all the way up in Toronto.
For me to make a city proud is like the best feeling, you know?
I just need to know, is my city, my hometown, ready to f- with me tonight, man?
Returning home, the once struggling local rapper was now a hometown superhero. Not to mention a heartthrob, bringing screaming girls to their knees.
The fans have gotten a little more intense, like
like throwing their panties and bras at you.
Yeah, like passing out and stuff like that. I had to stop my concert because four girls passed out, and it was like a medical emergency. And I saw one of them in the act. Like, she was literally, like, I was standing there on stage performing, and she was looking up, and she just dropped and hit her head, and I was so nervous.
The labels who once shunned the Toronto rapper for not conforming to the gangster stereotype had now changed their tune. And everyone came running to get a piece of Young Drizzy, sparking one of the most heated bidding wars in rap history.
Baby.
Oh, baby. Tonight, Kendra's new life comes with a new bundle.
Bam! There's so much going on.
Oh! A new crib.
On the road once again, baby.
And no instructions.
Oh, my God!
Crazy how life can change.
I'm still the same old Kendra. You know, I'm still the same old G. Yeah. Just with a bigger booty.
Size 26 is. I used to wear...
Boxing Day on TSN.
June 2009. After the huge success of Drake's third mixtape, So Far Gone, every major record label in the music industry wanted a piece of the young superstar, sparking one of the most heated bidding wars in rap history.
Labels want my name beside an X like Malcolm. Everybody got a deal. I did it without one.
But as the offers poured in and the bidding war reached a frantic climax, the young rapper simply sat back and enjoyed the ride. After all, he'd made it this far on his own.
Yeah, I'm just being patient. You know, it's a good time, man. We just go out for dinner and we talk and we discuss and, you know, but it'll come to fruition eventually.
In the end, loyalty prevailed, and Drake signed a lucrative deal between Aspire, Cash Money, and Young Money Records, cementing his bond and partnership with mentor Lil Wayne by remaining part of the Young Money crew.
I did it overnight. It couldn't happen any quicker.
Now that Drake was the hottest new name in hip-hop, everybody from Jamie Foxx to Mary J. Blige wanted him to appear on their album, and a slew of collaborations followed.
Who's that peeking in my window? You should let some more skin show. And if one of these websites get the info, we could work it out, no Nintendo.
Living the life of an A-list celebrity, the hot young star soon received his first taste of the paparazzi, appearing on gossip sites and tabloids around the world as rumors spread that he'd become romantically involved with pop princess Rihanna. Drake would neither confirm nor deny the rumors, but would go on to work with the pop superstar.
I understand that you're writing for Rihanna. How's that going?
It's great. I'm so happy for her. She has a phenomenal project. Yeah. I think she's going to shake up the world, you know? Yeah, she's great.
And before long, Drake had met and befriended almost every hip-hop legend in the game.
I've been blessed enough to be in the presence of people that I idolize, some of my heroes as far as this hip-hop game goes, and they embrace me.
Drake is the man. Come on, he's doing it.
Well, as far as MCing is concerned, he's nice on the mic. And that's what hip-hop is, MCing.
Heavyweights like Kanye West were so impressed with Drake's raw talent and potential to dominate the new generation of hip-hop that many offered to appear on the freshman's first full-length album, Thank Me Later. Set to drop near the end of 2009, it would become one of the most anticipated debut albums of all time.
Yeah, you know, I mean, I got a great song with Lil Wayne. I got a great song with Jay-Z. Kanye West did some great stuff on there.
It looked as though the sky was the limit. But the good times would come to an end on July 31st, 2009, when Drake collapsed on stage during a concert in Camden, New Jersey.
Unfortunately, he had fell on stage and messed his leg up. And since then, we ain't been able to get in the studio and get the song finished.
An old basketball injury had come back to haunt the rapper, and he was sidelined for several weeks. The album was ultimately delayed, and many wondered if the excitement and hype would last, or if the young sensation star would fade. Even Drake would begin to worry.
It's kind of like, all right, well, now you have to really release an album. That's what artists do. You know, they release records. So it's like, can you do that? Can excitement last all the way to the end of this year? You know, because that's when the album is going to come out.
2009 came and went, and still no album.
He proved that he's very talented, so he just has to maintain that focus because right now all the eyes are on him and not lose that.
I don't know what's going to happen. I always like to say I have a lot to prove, so.
January 31st, 2010. The Grammy Awards had arrived. Drake was still without an album, but back on his feet and faced the biggest performance of his career.
I had rehearsals today with Eminem, and he was just like, look, man, if you ever get nervous, just look at me in my eyes, and I'm gonna give you that reassurance, because I know you're gonna kill it. Don't ever doubt yourself, you know? And if you start to doubt yourself, look at me.
It was a make or break moment.
Last name ever. First name greatest, like a sprained ankle, boy, ain't nothing to play with.
Closing at the award show alongside Lil Wayne and Eminem, Drake nailed it and electrified audiences around the world with his hit song, Forever.
Everyone who doubted me is asking for forgiveness. If you ain't been a part of it, at least you got to witness.
In that moment, the torch was passed.
Young money. Yeah.
A few months later, Drake finally released what had become the most hyped and anticipated album in rap history.
And this is what I'ma do till it's over, but it's far from over.
All right, bottles on me, long as someone drank it, never dropped the ball. Y'all thinking?
I want to do this for the rest of my life. I finally found what I was meant to do. This is why I'm here, like, to give these people this music.
Picture, turn your widescreen on. If you thinking I'ma quit before I die, dream on. Man, they treat me like a legend. Am I really this cold?
Thank Me Later hit stores on June 15, 2010. And legions of loyal fans around the world showed their support.
He inspires me to be a better person and to, like, do my art the way that he does his art.
Oh, yeah, that's right. I'm doing me. I'm doing me. I'm living life right now, man.
Shooting straight to number one on the Billboard charts, Thank Me Later secured the young rapper's place in music history.
Nothing's gonna tear us apart.
June 20th, 2010. Returning home for the Much Music Video Awards in downtown Toronto, there was no question.
I love you. Thank you.
Drake was now the hottest star and undisputed king of hip-hop.
Toronto! I said I know way too many people here right now that I didn't know last year.
As Drake took the stage in front of thousands of screaming fans, it was a strong reminder that this was only the beginning for the young superstar.
What am I doing? What am I? Oh, yeah, that's right. I'm doing me. I'm doing me. I'm living life right now, man. This is what I want to tell us.
From his mom's basement in Forest Hill to king of the new rap world, Aubrey Drake Graham was born to be.
Give all I have to you, and I better find your loving. I better find your heart. I better find your loving. I bet if I give all my love, then nothing's gonna tear us apart.
labels want my name beside an X like Malcolm. Everybody got a deal. I did it without one.
He's the golden boy from Canada.
I'm proud to be Canadian, you know, that's all.
And the rap world's most promising new star.
I did it overnight. It couldn't happen any quicker.
Lil Wayne has taken him in like a little brother.
Wayne inspires me really to do all this stuff.
And he's worked with every legend in the game. From Jay-Z to Kanye West.
Everyone who doubted me is asking for forgiveness. If you ain't been a part of it, at least you got to witness.
With hip-hop royalty in his corner, he's on his way to an
H, you know, to be the best.
Hey.
Drake was born to be.
I can honestly say, you know, there was a period in my life where I was in high school, and I used to have trouble, you know, going to sleep at an early hour because I used to sit there and dream about hearing my name called, you know, at a Grammy nomination press conference, something like this.
Drake was at the Grammys, and with two nominations, the young rapper's meteoric career had reached an all-time high. The Pretty Boy MC looked like he should be fronting a bubblegum pop band, not rhyming alongside a tattooed and battle-scarred veteran like Lil Wayne. So as Drake stepped on stage to close out the 2010 Grammys with his smash hit Forever, millions of people around the world were watching.
Last name ever, first name greatest, like a sprained ankle, boy, ain't nothing to play with.
And everybody was waiting to see if the golden boy from Toronto could actually deliver. He'd become hip-hop's hottest freshman. But for every fan, there was a skeptic. The new rap star still hadn't released a full-length album. And many wondered if he was worth the hype. The last and only Canadian rapper to make it big out of the Great White North was Snow, an early 90s one-hit wonder. And as a former child TV star, Drake lacked the street cred and gangster persona many rap legends are made of, inheriting the throne of the new rap world.
It's about time you admit it, who you kidding, man, nobody's ever done it like I did it.
Legions of fans waited anxiously for his debut album.
I just want to be successful.
Making him the most hyped and anticipated rapper of all time.
One thing about music, when it hits you, feel no pain.
He represents the new generation.
I know this isn't it. I know this isn't the peak. I know there's always more to strive for, more to attain. The goal should always be to be one of the greatest.